found a few more bits, calipers and stuff, so water pump. So I'm just before I get any more stuff out, I think I'll just as well start refurbing this, to be honest. It's got to be done anyway, so I would suggest getting the bleed nipple out now whilst it's off the car and it's easy. I had to warm that one up a little bit to get it to move, but it's moving now. I'm just unsticking the pistons. I'm blowing blowing it up the pipe thing, but they're stuck still, so just soaking them at the moment, and I'm going to try and get them to go backwards, which seems a bit counterintuitive, but it gets them moving, you know. So I've had these soaking all night in WD-40 type stuff, and my normal process of pushing them out with the airline isn't working, so I'm going to be trying something different. Just making up something that I can use my grease gun on. The grease guns will put out several thousand psi of pressure. So if this works, I'll be a monkey's uncle. Get you back in a minute when we get rigged up. This grease gun is just an ordinary grease gun. And it's what I normally use for bleeding the brakes when I'm on my own. Years ago I'd worked on some 8-wheel tippers, DAF 85s, and their clutches. I'm just going to put some sort of soapy water in. And when it blows, if it does blow, then it won't make a horrible mess, just a clean mess, which my shed could definitely do with a bit of clean up. With a leak, who'd have had him and believed it? Anyway, these DAF trucks, when you did the clutches on them, clutch slaves on them, they didn't seem to like to be bled the traditional way. You had to bleed them backwards, so you had to make up a bit of a, on the side of the road one day, I had a coke bottle, a squeezy coke bottle, and a piece of pipe to push brake fluid back up the line, so back into the, and filled the pot up, you know, the muscles in the pot. Where am I looking? Oh, there it is. So I started doing everything this way, and it seems to work like a treat. You just need something that will bob around in the top of your mast cylinder so you can see it when it fills up. Otherwise you end up with brake fluid all over you. With brake fluid all over your lovely new paint, don't you? Anyway, this may or may not work. We'll give it a go. We may get covered in cleaner. What I'm going to do with the bath. So we'll see, won't we? We'll see what happens between us. Grab some copper washers in a minute. Work out what I've done with my banjo bolt. Close enough. The problem with this is it leaks out the back of the bottom of the gun, which is a pain in the butt. Obviously the pipe might just give go and we'll end up with, you and me will end up with clean on our faces. But like I say, we could do it in a wash, couldn't we? Not quite happening yet. Oh, yes, there is. What? Wasn't watching. See him coming out? Ah, oh, bless him. I wasn't watching. Look. Well, they wouldn't budge with the bloody air. Isn't that good? I'm proud chuff with that. Hey, that was it. Good enough. What a result. Who'd have had them and believed it, eh? So there you go, guys, if you we've learnt something together. If all else fails, rig up some wacky grease gun pump. I'll just show you what I was muttering about. I'd say normally I'll just shove my airline on the end. I've got plenty of pressure. Nothing. The trigger pulled right open. Not moving. Alright. So, do the same one with this one. It's exciting, isn't it? I like finding out new stuff. You see, I suppose it's handy if you've got lots of bits of old cars and old machines in your garage. It's quite useful. If you had to go out and buy all this crap, it wouldn't be worth it. Right, you watching? Oh, I've got a leak. So this copper washer is a bit big. So you going? That one? Well, this near side one ain't going, so this close one, so we'll have to stop that rascal off a bit somehow. Could do with a bit more mess on the bench, really. Try and get this one to go now. I don't know if you can see that or not. Just get your little close so you're in the line of fire. Yeah. Oh. Ah, me pipe let go. Oh. Right. Bring it back in a minute when I fix my pipe. I found some little teeny weeny O-ring O clips. So, I'll try these little perishers. I do like these. Well, I like them if they work in a minute. They don't work, I won't like them. They won't be their fault, will it? Really. Right, take two. Let's try it again. Well, I've got a wet leg. Well, it's coming out, but I'm losing more. Yeah, it's coming out, isn't it? See it? We've got a leak, fierce leak, but we're... Hey, that's it, she's gone. It's good fun, isn't it? Beautiful. That's all right, isn't it? Your fat fingers in there. Oh, yeah, bugger. Well, I could have a look at those. Well, I think we might need some new pistons looking at that. Well, that's the pistons out of them little rascals, and to be quite honest with you, they're what you might call buggered. So I think that was the worst one. I have a job to get that that's buggered to sell, haven't I? So when I get a new set of pistons, and that gives me a chance to clean them up. I've decided to go for black. I get some black gloss on them. I could have had red and yellow and fluorescent green and yeah, black. We're gonna go black. We'll have some stealth brake calipers. Right, so we'll get them bits on order and then we'll come back somewhere else with other bits of mischief we've been up to. Alright, see you in a bit. There's plenty to muck around with.